Oh, flip it up, baby. We're about to start. Yeah, go ahead, flip it up. Good luck, gentlemen.
Why are you wink at me? I don't like this. I don't do that.
There was a guy at the crafts table at Rivers. He was just like,
all right, everybody. We got
funny. Trent, he didn't want to see the seven. He's just like,
Trent and Frankie back in the booth here for the final. We are underway now. This has been a long, grueling day. You know, my ass is really hurting from sitting in this chair all day.
Holy, I can't. Shit.
These players have no idea what kind of struggle I've been through here watching some of this stuff. But you know, we're at the finish line here. We're right there.
I agree. Chris's needs new seats.
Yeah.
These chairs have been here since the 80s.
Among other things. They need some other stuff too.
Maybe a new carpet.
I think everybody would agree with that.
Absolutely.
I mean, first and foremost, pool hall, you want to keep the tables nice. All right, cool. I'm fine with that. But
when your foot gets stuck to the floor,
it's
kind of brutal.
All right, so Eddie got the first break. What is the race?
The race here is 7-4.
Wow. Okay. 4.
Now Eddie has overcame these large spots.
Long odds. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I know pre tournament he was griping a little bit about some of the odds, but I mean when you're at his level, you're going to be given games. That's just how it is. When you're
that good.
In theory, you're better than everyone else. You're going to have to try and find a way to equalize somehow, and that's why you chop the races shorter for the other players. Clean shot there. Gets the 5 off the rail. Makes it a little more manageable.
His problem ball is the 6.
I agree. It does clear. I think it clears past the 8 to the corner, though.
Okay. I think he's going to go 5-3-6.
I think so, 5-3-6, and then you got options with the 2 or the 1.
Beautiful shot.
Beautiful shot.
Great speed.
Yep.
Okay, so now
he's eyeing up the 6.
He's got to get perfect.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I can't tell on the bottom angle. I think he could run into the 10. That might be a little too far, though. I think he's got to try and come up just short of the 10. A little bit of a stun shot here. And he did run a little too heavy. He's going to have to jack up over this 10. I think he should still be okay, though. I can't tell from here. Is the 1 clear that 11?
It sure does.
All right, so I think that could be the next shot here.
No, he's definitely going. He has to go for the 6 now.
No, I meant after the 6.
Oh,
yeah.
After the 6.
Yeah,
okay,
after the 6. Unless he rolls it up just enough for the 2.
I like the 2 after. Great hit.
Great hit. Great hit.
Jack up. He might shoot the 1 all the way down.
I think 2 with some draw.
Does the 1 go on the side?
That's what I was asking. If it clears the 11.
I believe so. Yes, it does.
It goes in the corner, I believe, past the 14. So he could play this just a little bit of draw, take it off the side rail back for the 1 in the corner. I don't think he eyed that up though, so he might be pretty confident that the 1 can go on the side. Yeah, there's your draw off the rail. I think 1 in the side, you can play this slow, run into the 14, or you can play a little draw and take it 1 rail off the bottom rail. You got a lot of options here.
What do you like here?
I would probably draw this off the bottom rail because then I can take the eight in the side or the bottom corner.
Or any corner.
Yeah, yeah.
Give yourself better chances.
If you
yeah.
slow roll it and you lose your angle, you might get behind the 14. You might...
Or end up by the rail down
right,
there.
Exactly, right, exactly, exactly. I think playing draw and scooping it underneath all the problems, that just makes you a lot safer on the next shot.
I like it. It's just a tough angle, you know.
Correct, yeah. I think he's going to roll this up. He was looking at the 14, yep. And he got
it. Oh,
it
just got there.
Man.
He used all of that pocket.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And that was an exhibition rack right there.
There you go. And ladies, that's why he is a 7-2.
Yes. That is the first game for Eddie Balderas. 1-0, Eddie Balderas.
Yeah, Ricky to break. You know, I think that rack he had... pretty steady pace.
Yeah.
Compared to the first couple matches. Thank you, Rob, for showing up. Great playing.
Have a good one.
Great playing. See you, senior. Oh, I don't want no smoke, man.
All right, Ricky okay, DeBrake here. Let's see what he can do. All right, he's made a ball.
We got it. Where's the cue ball going?
Cue ball has scratched. That is unfortunate. So we got some stripes on the rail here, solids on the rail.
Right there, Eddie.
Yeah. If the two clears the 11, it'd be a great breakout ball for the 5.
What do you think, DJ?
Oh, he's elected to choose stripes. He got the 8 out of there.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. All right, so it looks like maybe a little bit off of the 14 contact. Let me take the... Oh, we got it clean. Okay, I didn't need the 14. I said, screw your 14. I don't need it. I think this is pretty straightforward here. You take the 12, roll it up a little bit. You go 14, 10, 9.
Yeah. He's got to get really good on his 9 ball.
Yeah. If he's straight in on the 14, then he can do whatever he wants. He can draw back off the 10. As long as you're a little bit above...
I think
above.
You take the 14 now. Why clear it later?
That's, you know, yeah.
It's like you go 14, 9, you know what I mean?
I think it could be a safety valve. Like if you're a little bit off, right. You got a lot of room to make that somewhere. All right. Maybe he takes the 9 here now. He came up a little short for sure. You take the 9. Yeah, but the 8 doesn't go in the corner, so I don't like finishing with the 10 ball.
No. Ideally, you wanted to come back up, take the 10, come back to the middle,
right.
14, 9,
yeah.
8 in the side.
Yeah.
He wants to save that 9 ball for
you can set up the 10 ball next, then you're still golden because you can use the 14 to come underneath for the 8.
Absolutely.
So, but I don't know if the angle's great here. Yeah, he's gonna
looks pretty steep.
He's gonna draw this, try and get underneath for the 10. I think that's what we're thinking.
Come back to the center of the table.
Yep.
Oh, he hung it.
And Ricky has a chance here. He's got some work to do for sure.
Well, he elected to go 9, 14, 10, probably draw back on the board. That's,
yeah.
That's a tough one.
Doable, just certainly harder.
Yeah. See, in those moments, you ought to walk around a table. And you know, over multiple.
We don't need any more walking around from Eddie. He's done plenty of that. Plenty of that.
I think that's why we're still here at
7:20
at night.
Well, we did also elect to stream the other semifinal. We could have played that simultaneously, but you know, we wanted to give you all your viewers a little bit something more to look at.
Absolutely. Why not? You know.
Yeah. And they had already seen enough of Eddie. We needed to show some other players.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We had guys painting.
Yeah, painting the fence. Watching Eddie.
Painting the fence. Kind of in a tough position. He's only got a combo to shoot at, or he's got to cut the six. That's a tough shot.
Yeah.
Or he's gonna either elect to play. I would play safe. Maybe duck behind the five ball. But you have to get there.
Yeah, you got to be perfect though, because the nine is just sitting right in the jaw.
Absolutely.
And I mean the 14 is, I'd say kind of kickable as well with it sitting right there. All right. So he's going for the only. In theory, clean make that he has, but it's
right.
Great shot.
What a shot.
Does he get rewarded? All right, we had a little bit of a hand touch there, so you have to replace the two ball back where it was.
It's like it was in the same spot, but he moved it back to the same spot. The same thing just moved over.
All right, now we might get a three ball attempt here.
I think if he cut the four real thin, he can come around the backside and hit the two ball.
It's a lot of cue ball travel though. Ooh, the two hangs up. If that would have rolled down the rail, that would have made things a lot harder.
It hit the nipples and came off in his favor.
Yeah.
Very fortunate. We call that a jelly roll.
All right, I'll take your word for it. All right, so if we cut the two, there's a chance you can spin into the five if you need it.
I'd say I hit this with inside comeback straight. See, because if not,
this is gonna be tough. Yeah.
Oh, he still got the seven.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you definitely called that though. You gotta play inside.
Oh yeah. Or outside.
And spin it a lot more. Anything other than what he did. But he ended up with a little bit of a safety there. Safety valve. Okay, that's...
Maybe he might have rushed it. He could have rolled the 7 and played the 14. And shot the 5 off the 14.
Mm-hmm.
You just have to be. You have to weigh your options. Here we go.
All right. So Eddie slow rolls this one. I think.
It's routine.
You play the 10 clean.
Absolutely.
Yeah. 10 clean. A little bit of a draw. Or you could even just leave it right there. Come off the rail. Right back out. Yep. Just a little baby draw here should set him up for the 8. Yep, there it is. And Eddie's going to go up 2-0. There it is. We got Eddie to break. We noticed on his first rack, he elected to blow it up. He did not do his quote-unquote... unsuccessful break, as he likes to call it. Doing a tight press, wasn't fiddling, so I think we have another blowout break here.
All right, well, we're gonna see what type of power he comes with.
Yeah,
that's for sure. No, I don't think so. Beautiful break. What?
Something fall. He was having dry break problems earlier.
And he's drier than the desert.
We got nothing here. Okay, the 211 is definitely weird. If you take solids, that 2 becomes a problem. And you don't have any clean makes on a stripe right now. So this is definitely a thinker for Ricky right now.
I think I would have So Ricky chose stripes. His only problem ball is the 11. He's going to have to generate some type of angle to get back down there.
Yeah.
But also the 13. 13 goes in the corner, but he has to make it. Actually, it looks like it goes in both corners.
Yeah, I think he might end up playing that 11 as a bank shot. I don't really see how else he's going to handle it. Might try and... Nah, you can't really play safe and hide behind it. So there's no way to open it up and still stay safe.
I mean, he could bank it back. I mean, that's just...
Well, I was
turning it loose.
Yeah, I was more so looking at the 11. I'm saying, like, you could try and hide behind there, but it doesn't benefit you, really, because you're still not going to open it up.
Right, right. Yeah, I think in the previous shot, he should have used that shot to get back down on the 12 ball.
Yeah.
To look for an angle to get down there. He's in a pickle now.
I think he's loading up for a bank. Tried to cut it. Cue ball
actually
ends up
not
all the way
bad.
Down.
It's not a bad leave. Not a bad leave.
Anybody with a 7 on the side or 7 all the way down? I don't like it in the side. It changes too much of the table layout.
Yeah, I would agree. I think what I'd like as far as playing safety is coming off the 2 ball, hiding behind the 3 ball, maybe leaving him a bank on the 12 ball.
Okay, yeah. Would you play that rail first? Because I don't know if you can see the right edge of the 2.
No, I would not. Oh,
all right. So he goes for the 7. Looks like he's eyeing up the 5 ball right now. If he can hold his position, he might be able to have an angle to use the 3 and open up the 2. So for those of you at home watching, he's putting the 3 ball near that pocket so he can use that later to break out his 2 ball. More of a prophylactic move.
Thanks for playing. Glad you came. It's a good showing. Not for Goya, though.
Nima, good to see you. You're my favorite shortest person in the world.
All right, what do we got from Ricky? Looks like
there we go. It looks
safe,
like a nice
trying,
safe
trying
move.
To hide in the corner. This could be fantastic.
Oh, he just Ooh, leaked it out.
Just leaked him out. I think Eddie can see the 4 ball. Probably sees the 6 as well. I don't think he can do anything with it, but... Yeah, I think the 4 ball's the choice here. The 6 is still going to be tricky later. But if he can make this 4 on the side, well, hell, maybe he can make it in the corner. I don't think he can see all of it like that, but I think he's looking at where his cue ends up. And then calls the safety, I believe I heard. Maybe he said 6. I couldn't hear what he said. He did. He called the safety.
There you go.
And he ties up another one of Ricky's balls here.
It is good. That's smart play.
Opens up his 6 ball because he couldn't do anything with it before. And he also ties up Ricky's ball. So that was a nice double result that Eddie was hoping for there.
I think if I'm Ricky here, I'm pushing my balls down table.
Get everything on that side.
Get everything back down that side because you could have the same type of... You know, if you get a chance, you use your balls to still break out other
correct, yeah,
other balls.
Because I mean, obviously Eddie has that 3 as a breakout ball, but technically Ricky's 11 is still in front position ahead of that 2. Oh, he calls the 11 and gets it.
But he should have took care of the cue ball.
Yeah, I think he was just kind of firing at it. He's unhappy about his position on the table. Now he's gonna be in real trouble here.
He could back cut this, but
I think that's what he just looked at. Yep, calls the 13. He's gonna back cut it. If he can clip that 6 ball, that would be. He plays it slow. Clips the 12. That's gonna leave it open for Eddie.
It's not a bad leave.
No, it's not. I think
he's gotta make the. If he doesn't make the 4 ball, he's in trouble.
Yeah, the 10 is blocking his 3 ball, and he can't see the 5 or 6 to make them anywhere. Effectively, rather. Right. Yeah, I think he plays this four up in this bottom corner, up top corner up here. And
if he makes the four, he's got home free.
Yeah, he's got the six, he's got the three. It's.
But he's always jacked up over the five ball.
He is, yeah.
It's a tough shot, but.
Eddie agrees. He's disgustingly looking at the table. Shakes his head.
Rolls his eyes. Rolls
it, yeah, of course. Like he's not up 2-0. And,
you know, that's.
This is the Eddie waiting games that we were used to before.
So you have three options here. You could play a safety, which he's looking like he's likely to do, or kick,
hide it behind the 13.
Make the four ball or kick the six in.
Yeah, he's going to hide it right in the corner.
Oh, he scratches.
Anyone else, he can't do it.
Bad bond.
Over here.
Excuse me? Hey, can I have my Gatorade?
Right. So we know what Eddie was trying to do there. Obviously, just didn't get it. Uncharacteristic.
We got
to
get you on the
there.
Camera.
If the 10 passes the 3, which I don't think it does, I think Ricky's going to try and open up this 12 ball using the 13. That's the angle he's looking at right now. I think he might take the 10 ball first just to get that out of the way.
I would put some angle on that because
I think he's going to try and come underneath it. Yeah. Problem with that, though, is you don't. You're pushing the ball towards a pocket you can't make.
He should have bumped the 12 out.
He should have come
towards the side
on top of the 12 instead of from behind. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. It looks like we're looking at a forced combo.
It's not always good because then the 12 might lay by the
exactly
low percentage shots.
Very low percentage. And
but
he drills
he
it.
And he gets
beautiful
shape.
That's a home run shot right there.
Oh my God.
Shot of the match thus far. Now he just has to finish it. Should be pretty straightforward. A very, very, very strange shot choice. He wanted to come straight out and he drew it back too far. Obviously you can still make this 8, but he just made it a lot harder than it needed to be. Calls it in the corner.
Look at all the emotions and that being amped up, you know.
Adrenaline.
Good shot.
He still gets 8. That was good out. Good out. I nominated that combo as the shot of the match.
Yeah, you can sure. Clap. Yeah. You can clap. Yeah. Yeah. Clap is loud.
No whispering?
No.
No, the reverberation in the mic, it's not good. Yeah, clapping's okay, but the whistling is too high frequency.
What about like fans in the background with like flags?
The thunder sticks? Or the boom sticks, whatever they call them? Yeah, foam noodles and stuff. Yeah. All right. So we have anybody commenting anything interesting we need to address, or are we just everybody watching?
Oh, there's quite a few people. Quite a few people commenting.
Trick shot exhibition. Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. These guys are making the outs harder than they really should be.
Yeah. It's more entertaining for the viewers, right?
Yeah, I guess so. Make it small. Make it spontaneous.
Right. Bad Bunny, bye bye.
A lot of Bad Bunny fans out there.
Hey, you know, I like him.
I like him too. I think, is he trapped?
He could be I'll use Gopal's reference from before. It could be in a sarcophagus of a safety.
He could probably clip the nine. I think he's got the nine in there. Unless the seven's like all the way in his way, I can't tell.
He's got the nine.
Yeah.
He's got a draw to bump to five. Or just follow straight through.
I was going to say, if you follow through, you could...
You open everything up, you know? You might hold it for the 12 on the side.
The cord fell. So I was wondering if it jacked up the camera, but...
Oh, right. We're good.
And we have the pacing back and forth from Eddie.
Song said, needs a break clinic after this. I would agree, Song.
Yes. Smooth. And he did hit the five, as you might have expected. So we got the 12 inside.
But he didn't follow up, because if he had an angle, if he followed up, he would have had the angle to track back down.
Right.
So
right.
Now he has to make it even harder, go back up table.
He's got to come all the way off the top rail, all the way back down.
With traffic.
And you got to spin it just to get even, because if you just go straight up and down, you won't have...
You won't have shape on either ball.
Yeah, so you've got to try and navigate a lot of balls here to get all the way down and have a shot. I actually think the safest choice would be going around the six and the two. I think.
Yeah, coming back at the
back
end.
You have one isolated line to get through, whereas if you're coming the other way, you got to miss the five, miss the one, miss the eight. There's.
That's your natural line. I mean, you could spin it with like inside and come back that way, but you're flirting.
Right.
I mean, here I think maybe coming off the rail. And behind the one and the eight ball, you know what I mean? Finding that line.
Yeah, it actually is almost the identical line. It's just you're putting inside instead of outside.
Right. I think I like the outside choice because it's just natural. Like, let the ball float down.
Right.
So he's looking at the line.
Yeah, he's looking at coming behind the one ball.
Actually, he might go two rails. The two rail line.
Okay.
Hit
yeah.
The first diamond come off.
Yeah.
In between the one
yeah,
and the eight ball.
I think that's what he's eyeing up. A little extra, let's see, for him it'd be extra right hand spin.
Mm-hmm.
And then coming kind of landing on the top rail somewhere around the first diamond.
Yeah.
And then hooking into the side rail about the middle diamond and then coming all the way down to where he just put his chalk. That little Z pattern, I guess.
He's flirting with the side if he doesn't hit it good.
Correct, yep. If he gets too much top and not enough side.
Oh, yeah.
Huge whack. Right. Eddie straight left. Almost fully set.
Baba.
All right, now he sets. That's we hope for the shot. Final time. I think he's finally ready to take this shot.
What is he like?
There's one. Oh, wow, that was some very interesting spin that we definitely did not see happen.
Hey, BJ called that one. He's at top left.
Now the question is, was BJ just guessing or did he actually know that was going to happen?
Okay. He actually knew.
Okay. So now Eddie's looking at, after making the 15, he's going to try and hit this bottom rail to where the cue ball runs into the 5 to prevent him from going all over the place.
Or he just might want to draw back into it, but that's not ideal.
Yeah, if your 14 gets too high, then you lose all your opportunity to make it.
Yeah, he's spinning.
Yeah.
You don't want to spin too much because you might just get hooked.
Yeah. And he does hit the 5. A little bit high on the angle, though. The one benefit for Eddie, though, is that this is a natural lead for the 8. All he has to do is play this with simple topspin. Maybe 11 o'clock. And you just come right up down the center of the table.
I like that. Just float it on in.
Mm-hmm. And usually shots like these on the rail are easier to make using inside English, but if you were to do that, he'd have no 8 ball, so he's got to kind of backtrack the spin.
He might hit a little hard, and he does have
a little extra spin on it. He's going to run into the 7.
Oh, he just barely gets there.
Not the easiest cut, but certainly should be makeable for him.
He almost gave himself a heart attack.
Yep.
Any slower, he would have been locked to that seven ball.
And we have the patented Eddie pacing now.
You like your Frankie the Banker cut. You like your Banker cut.
The cut for sure. Absolutely. It goes all day, but we don't want to hang it up. We popped. We gotta cut this ball. Cut this ball with
finally set down here.
Cut this ball with a touch of inside to hold it.
Yep.
And let it go.
Beautifully done.
There you go.
Beautifully done, and we have a 3-0. 3-1. 3-1 lead now.
3-1. We have a 4-3 race on our hands. Can Ricky fade the bull? Can he dodge him, should I say? You mess another, with the bull, you get the horns.
Quick press rack here from Eddie, so he should be blowing this out again. I think we've seen enough of his the slug rack, so he's done with that.
There it goes.
Center ball break.
Oh, he got one ball.
He does get a ball to drop. What this table, he's just insanely open. The 13-2-12 on the bottom rail is really the only thing to give pause about, but there's really nothing here that should pose a problem.
Nine's a lot of balls close to me.
Yeah.
So that little constellation of this rock should be pretty easy to land on.
Yeah. The eight ball's right in the middle.
Yes, father.
It's with the nine, though.
Oh, hit that with inside. Pissed him off to get it.
Thought he might have rattled it. He caught that in about the middle diamond.
Yeah, still. They called that the shooter's touch when you could hit the second middle diamond and still get it to go.
Where he needs to be for the 13. So we got 12, 13. What do you think? 10 ball next after the 13.
Oh, good bump. Sometimes you gotta nudge a ball.
Yeah, just tickle it a little bit. You know, slide it out of the way.
Do whatever it takes to get the job done.
Yes.
And the angle looks like such he doesn't quite get trapped in the bottom rail.
I think he skirts this back. He's looking at the 10 next. He could come all the way back for the 14, but I think 10's probably the safest way to go if he can get it out.
He's going inside, top inside. Yes, he is. He's going to spin it right back out to get on the 14
now. We bypassed the 10 for the 14.
That was a beautiful shot.
I think we go 14 to the 11 here.
Thaddeus, if you brought your pom-poms, you could be our one and only cheerleader.
I don't think he got enough for the 11, so he's got to go 10 here.
Oh, he's electing.
Maybe the 9.
He's got the two, but this is
he put his hands in the air like he was about to surrender until a ball dropped.
I thought you were going to say like he just didn't care, but
in the way you were going there, that's really where I thought it was going. But,
that was good. I can kind of understand that because like also too, when you're breaking and kind of a sort of repeatable break, like the second ball break, when the balls that you really depend to them don't start going, like that probably would be a cause for concern.
Yeah. Well, I think it's like, okay, you see how he hit the second ball break and they all kind of like just, they're not really scattered. He's lack of confidence because it's a lack of focus. It's like, you know what I mean? Instead of bearing down and aiming at the spot you know you need to hit at.
Yeah, you're just banging it into an area.
He's just pointing, shooting, and not really thinking, and that's why you get that result. Yeah. So you have to bear down on the break. You have to prepare. It's so important to do that. A lot of players forget.
One thing we overlooked, Ricky has taken off his sweatshirt. He's, maybe the heat of the moment, he's got to cool down a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely.
The hat is still on, though. I think that's the last thing to come off.
Yeah, no. Take the hat off. That's it. He's going to lose his coconuts.
Yeah.
We definitely don't want that.
Yeah. Looks like he's taking it, so safe shot, but I don't think it accomplished anything.
Yeah, now that sound ball is going to be very easy to get to.
That one is on the rail. I mean, I don't know if easy is the word I'd use, but it's certainly get to able.
Oh yeah.
That's also not a word, but I think we follow what I'm trying to say. We have a safety from Eddie. The last couple racks have been pretty open for him, so we haven't seen much of that lately. But this has kind of been a messy break. Kind of had no choice.
Oh, I'll be right back.
Got a hit watch request from Eddie. So we could briefly welcome BJ to the booth. How's it going, BJ?
What's going on there, Trent?
You think Eddie takes this down? You think Ricky can come back?
I like always cheer for the underdogs here, and I'm a huge fan of Eddie Balderas, but you know what? I would love to see Ricky make a run at the money for this.
Eddie does win a lot. Like, it would be nice to see some other people get a little bit of reward for the effort.
Yeah. Ricky has done something to get this far, so
exactly.
I hope he can make a little strong showing here and try to at least get close to the end here and try to make it bat out to like one or two games.
I mean, if Ricky can manage to win this one, which that's not going to help, but I mean, it's still a 3-3 race right now.
Yep, still a 3-3
despite
race.
Despite being down 4-1, it's only a 3-3 race at this point, so... It just takes one to get into rhythm. Then if it's your break, you might get a break and run. I mean, things can happen real fast. You just got to find a way to get that game to kind of open the floodgate. Calls a safety here. I think he's going to float behind the one.
Yep.
Didn't quite get there. But I believe he blocked. It's tough to tell. We're on the far end of the table. I think he's got enough of it to block the 15.
He's got a shot at the 10 down. It looks like. That's the only thing I can see.
Now it looks like the 12 and the 9 are jammed up for a combo. Mm-hmm. You're going to have to take the 12 all the way down. It's going to be tough here. the one saving grace for Ricky is that Eddie's one ball is still in a pretty tough spot to get to. The seven is a good ball to help get to it, but you're still kind of guessing at how the cue ball comes off on that. Takes the 12 down table, looks a little heavy. It is. I think if Eddie's going to try and run out, this is his shot to open up the one ball.
Right here.
Just a little bit of side spin right here into
it. Yep.
There it is. But...
oh, he tied up his other two balls.
He tied up the side pocket just barely. I think he still has both balls, but now he's underneath the one, so he's going to have to...
take three down?
I think you got the six in the corner. That's what he's looking at right now. You do have the three all the way. If the angle's straight, you can take the three all the way and then get the four ball next. I think that's the choice. Even if you're running to the five, it just makes the five better, if not also in. So I think the three all the way is...
that's what he looks like. He's going to probably roll it up a little bit.
Yeah, roll it up, and then you get the four ball
next.
There
we go. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Now he could choose to spin this into the five and just get it away, but I think the five goes, the five's dead center pocket. You don't even need to move it.
Nope. He's going to come back and have the five. Watch this. He's going to hit the five and come back up on this long rail to get the six in the corner.
I think the six is the next shot after the four.
After the four, really?
After the four, yeah. You play this with a little, like maybe a little 11 o'clock English. You come off the rail straight back out.
Okay.
Then you can take the six to come off the top rail all the way down.
I think we got an injury on field.
There's a coin dispenser on the side of the table, and Eddie just
we need a medic.
Clocked it with his knees.
We need a medic.
he's really milking it here. I mean, there was definitely an audible bang. I have no doubt that there was a little bit of discomfort there, but.
Here we go. There you go. Looks so like the six is there.
He overcooked it a little bit here, I think you play this with just a heavy draw. You come all the way down the table for one, and then you finish five. And if you don't make it, let's say you run into the eight, or you just don't hit it hard enough, then you don't always take the five and then come back.
Okay. While we're waiting for Eddie Balderas' next shot, I just want to send a quick shout to all the pool fans in the APA community who are still with us throughout this whole day for the Lucky 16 tournament here live at Chris Billiards.
Yeah, we've been live for about 7 hours now.
7 hours and going strong. There we go.
So he's going for the one. I think you spin inside. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What a leave.
Yep. Now you can pick your poison. You can come five with draw back to the six, or you can play six, come off the top rail, and then finish with the five. It's
what would really be your pick, Trent? What would you go for?
I think I would go six, then five.
Yeah, I prefer six, too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. The only thing, you just want to make sure you don't run this back too far, and then you might block yourself at the eight ball. But okay. There's a ton
also
of...
don't get too thin on the five ball here.
Look at the speed control.
Yeah, the speed is great. He can draw this back down to the bottom rail, or he has enough angle to just thin cut this, play two rails out, or real soft and play the eight in the side pocket. I mean, there's so many options here.
So
I think he's just
going to
hit it soft, play the eight, cross center. Yep.
There we go.
Silky smooth.
Another very tight run-up.
Yeah, it was.
Lovely cue ball.
Ricky had that chance early, and then when he missed that ball in the corner,
it's just a few haphazard shots.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That'll do it. We are now at 5-1. Eddie Balderas 5-1. He is two games away from the $1,000 payout.
Like I tell everybody in sports, and all my sports fans, it's never over till it's over. Ricky still needs to.
We noticed Ricky has put the sweater back on.
Yes, he has.
So maybe he was hot for a little minute, cooled off.
Yeah. You know what's interesting?
Well, you know
what?
Have
you guys ever heard of anchor theory? Like for sports psychology, believe it's called anchor theory. Like certain things are like comfort tools or whatever. Like Magnus Carlsen, the world's number one chess player. For a while, his anchor used to be orange juice. That was his trait for quite a bit. But then usually for some reason, like, they stop. Maybe it's just, like, superstition or...
It could be a superstition thing. He made it this far with the sweater on. Maybe he's like, all right, I got to put this thing back on. But
you know, maybe he betrayed the sweater, though, by taking it off in the first place. So hopefully the damage isn't there.
Right. So Eddie has a chance to break and run again. I think Salazar
is
the choice.
Salazar's the cues to go.
Yeah, we're all in agreement on that.
Salazar the balls.
If I had a choice to start, I would actually start with the six ball here. I think that's what he's eyeing up. It's going to be the hardest ball to get to, and he has a natural angle to just draw this back out to really take any other ball on the table.
Like,
I don't think the 10 is in the way.
Oh, he wants to. Oh no, he's thinking about it again. No, he right. wants to start.
He might want to reposition his angle, seven. So he's going to start with the 7 and basically try and get the cue ball back to where it was. A little too heavy. So I think we're going to. Think we're gonna have another attempt at it here.
We got a special song request from the man himself, Frankie, aka the Pescado.
Alright, so now
we got that throw baby on the jukebox.
Three or the four here.
What we say, throw baby.
Throw baby.
Alright, I guess he has the angle for the 6, so we're gonna see this attempt here. Kind of draw it straight back or kind of cross. Gets it. Didn't get over for the three lined up, but he does have the 1 ball. We can play this off the top rail, come right back for the 3-4 again.
3-4. Definitely.
That's what he's looking at right now.
Though. Let's see. He's still going.
Yeah, I think he would have preferred to save that 1, but I mean. When your hand is forced, you got to do what you got to do. So he's going to take the 1. It looks like off the top rail, come back out for better position on the 3 and the 4. There it is.
Nice and smooth. Now,
personally, I would take the 4 ball here. There's a little bit of an angle. You can use the side rail.
A little bit of draw, right?
Yep. You can use the side rail to reposition back out for basically the same angle again on the 3.
Okay.
I'd say this little cluster over here, you're near the side rail, kind of resembles the L rail. If you could...
I don't think so, but it's like we were just saying, you can just subtle draw and you got it right in the side pocket. I think he takes the, looks like he's setting up for the 3. And jerk over for the 5 next. Well done. Very well done.
Very well placed.
Now he can play this back out. I think he goes 5, then the 4.
Okay.
Finishes with the 2, either in the corner or the side. Depends on where he ends up. And he finishes the 8 in this same pocket he's shooting at now.
Let's see.
All right. So his angle came up a little short. So now he's going to be forced to go 2 ball in the side. Finish with the 4 in the corner. And then if your angle's right, he can draw it. Play the 8 in the opposite corner, or he can roll up and play the 8 in the side pocket.
Okay.
So I think you play the 2 here with a little bit of draw. Try and get as straight as you can on the 4.
Just to the end rail and back up.
The question is, what are the odds right now Ricky gets another shot in this game?
I'm at this point, I think it's 0. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say 0. Alright, came out a little heavy, so I think the play here is you make the 4 in the corner, you get a little side draw action, and you take the...
Oh! Sorry, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we have technical difficulties. Man down. Camera phone down. Man down.
The stream has fallen from the ceiling.
Eddie Balderas does not check his surroundings, obviously. He's so zoned in on the game.
Now the camera can feel my fear.
If that would have hit Eddie in the head, I wonder if he would have tried to call an injury foul.
Luckily, we got the crew on standby, willing to take care of the situation pronto, ASAP.
Yeah.
Let's see here. Bear with us, fans.
If the phone would have fallen on the table.
That's throw baby.
All right, we're attempting to get this back up.
Is it back up?
It's up, I mean, but we're trying to see the...
It's mounted.
Hey, Frank, we got Frankie's big old face.
Taking a chance to get a close-up here.
You might have to...
Turn the camera so they can see the setup. Turn the... Yeah.
This one?
Yeah.
Frankie, hold on. Move it. Yeah, right. A little more to the right, Frank.
No, your left.
Right there. No. Little up. Right there.
Yeah, that'll work.
That's fine.
All right, sorry, folks.
That'll
That'll do. Had a major. After 7 hours, the phone just got tired, you know? It was like, you know what, screw this.
No, I think Eddie took a nice... hold on, stay still. No, I think Eddie took a nice little whack at it.
Yeah, he was a little angry. came out a little heavy on that four ball position.
No, Eddie went like, I think back cue and...
I went like this.
All right, I think we're back in business. Yeah, we're good, Frankie.
Shout out to Crystal Feliciano in the building. Isa. Can't hear me. We got the music loud. It's Saturday night here. ¿Cómo estás?
All right.
All righty.
Back to business here.
Back to the action, folks. Sorry for the delay. Again, thank you for your patience. Again, we're here live at Chris Billiards for the Lucky 14, or 16, excuse me, Lucky 16 tournament. We are here in the final match for $1,000. What do you think, Trent?
$1,000.
I think on this shot right here, we just play all draw. You're going to have natural angle off the side rail. Cue ball is going to come right back out to the center of the table. You take the 8 in the same pocket. That's how I would play this shot. And obviously, Eddie is better than me, so he might have other plans, but I think the idea is the same. Looks like he's loading up for just a pure draw shot, as we said. Some of us players think alike. Right off the side rail,
all left,
here right back to the middle of the table. And now he did overrun it a little bit, but this is not an angle that he should miss. This will be Eddie's second break and run of his breaks in a row.
Wow.
Obviously, with alternating breaks, they're not back-to-back, but in theory, they are back-to-back.
Here we go.
He has dropped the 8 to be on the hill. Eddie Balderas is one game away from the $1,000 grand prize. Only prize, actually. There's only one pay.
So, Trent, you're in Ricky's corner.
What would you say? Honestly, I've known Ricky long enough to know, he doesn't really care what you have to say right now. He's all up in his own head. He just needs to focus. That's what I would tell him.
Control your brain.
Control the emotion is what it really is. Those of you that know Ricky, he can be an emotional player.
Yep.
He elected to kind of slow down the game a little bit. Might have slipped. I don't know. It's tough to tell. But he did actually drop a couple balls.
He did. And honestly, if I've known Ricky for a couple years now, and he is kind of an emotional player. But at the same time, me learning to be a captain of a team, I always tell my players, whether you're ranked 7 or 2, doesn't matter. You take one ball, one stroke, one game at a time. It's not over till it's over. He just got to stay focused, stay down, bear with it. And just grind it out.
Beautiful shot there to open the 11. Unfortunately, is now tied up the 8 ball.
Yes. You just got to stay focused.
Tied up the 8. Does he have full view?
He has full view, yeah. Full view of the 11.
Now, the 8 looks like it's not tied up to the point where it won't bank.
That is correct. It would be bankable if it's necessary. I think right now, Ricky's just going to try and make some balls. Get to a position where he's like, you know what? Just screw it. I'm going for everything because I don't know if that's the right way to play. In theory, you should play tighter, but whatever he's been doing thus far hasn't worked. So maybe he's just thinking, I gotta just go for it.
Oh, shout out to young Benny Ruiz, aka Frankie's Broski, in the house. Just walked in the building. But again, like I said, one ball, one stroke, one game at a time.
Now, I can't tell from our vantage point, but is the angle proper to where he could open up the eight ball here with the 15 in the side?
It looks like he's been on the wrong side.
It looks pretty straight in. I don't know if he can cheat the pocket enough to create an angle. He forces it, and he gets it. Unfortunately, he just hit it too good, actually. Too well, rather.
Really down table.
The 14 goes clean. I think that's a shot. Wow, nice little split pack there. Oh, and once again, he's...
But where's the future? Like, I would have probably saved you on a ball.
Well, you can play safe now. If you send the cue ball down to this side of the table, it's going to be really hard for Eddie to play a safety back.
That's true, but to take out that extra ball, really are not leaving yourself.
I like that safety. Puts a ball on each side of the table.
Good.
Okay, I do.
The 8 is obviously still plugged up, but Eddie has got
he can come up
a real bundle down here. That
I
he's
feel
got.
Like this is where
looks like it's laying pretty naturally.
Here's where your one pocket experience comes in here.
Absolutely, he did leak it out. The 10 ball is now very makeable.
Okay.
And the 8 has some room. It's not a clean pocket to anywhere on the table. However,
you have some spin.
There is some space. There is if you can put this 10 in, create a little bit of back cut angle on the 13, you can really do some damage to that 8 being blocked. Alex for the cut.
There is
a possibility he can go all the way under the pack, take the 8 in the same pocket, but you literally have to be perfect. You have to basically
how are you hitting this ball, Trent?
I'm gonna run into the pack. Hope I get the 8 to the other side.
Here we go. Get in there. Oh.
So, I think he has to bank this now. I don't really see another way to get to it.
Is the bank open? Let's see. I don't know.
Yeah, I think that's what we were just talking. Yeah, he's called it inside.
That's a really big window for the bank.
Yeah, he is. He's called it in the side. There's no risk of scratching. You just got to make this. He's looking at maybe putting it into the 7. I don't. Eddie wants to take a look to make sure there's no risk of fouls. All right, it looks like the call is in. He's changing his mind. He's going to the corner. He's going to try and float this past the 7 ball.
I actually kind of like this. Let's see.
Missed it by quite a wide margin.
Yeah.
Shorten it up mid-table.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Ricky might have rushed that one. Yeah, he should have took a little more time on that shot.
Nervous about hitting the 4 ball. And yeah, that was...
Now the table looks wide open here. Let's see if Eddie Balderas can close this tournament out.
I don't know if I would have played it the same way there. I think I would have tried to get rid of those balls on the rail.
On the short rail first?
Yeah.
With the 6 open.
But he can finish with the 6 and the 2, which I believe he'll do. He'll draw this back for the 4 in the corner. Interesting way to do it. He could have just come naturally across, but he elected to showboat a little bit there.
Mm-hmm. Very nice confidence stroke.
Yeah, for sure.
I know some people say it's showboating. I feel like it's just confidence and experience comes into play. This man's been playing for so many years.
A little bit of a flex.
Yeah, I think he could adapt to any.
And to Gopal's point, I don't think he was intentionally doing it. He just knows that he can.
Yeah, so
he's like,
that's right.
I'm going to take this shot because he can take this shot.
He can get away with it.
Exactly.
Here we go.
And he creates just enough angle. He's just going to float this down.
Yep. Just enough to stay by the rail, but it's
weight. Yeah.
A little bit of check aside.
Ricky looks quite dejected and defeated, but don't let that get to you. Probably had a great day today. No, just ran into a monster here at the end.
They say some days you're the bug and some days you're the windshield.
Yeah, that's all I say is, Ricky, if you watch this later, keep your head up, man. You had a great run. And shout out to all the other pool players that were in this Lucky 16 tournament today. It was a great turnout, great showing. But it looks like Eddie Balderas is zoned in and ready to close this game out. Let's see.
It's pretty much dead straight in. Mm-hmm. This is a $1,000 shot. And Ricky concedes. Gives it to Eddie. There you have it. Eddie Balderas is your Lucky 16 winner.
Ricky.
It's been a day.
Ricky,
I'm sure.
You had him, man. You did great today, bro. You had a great run.
That's right.
Sucks that you play all day. You don't use people.
Good shot.
Congrats. Great run.
Yeah, it was okay.
I don't know what Nima has planned for the post-tournament presentations and whatnot, but this is Trent the Suit. It's been a pleasure commentating for you throughout the day. I am going to sign off as my ass is hurting from sitting here all day. I'm gonna pass this off to another. I'm gonna pass this off to.